CCTV election bill. Thank you. First of all, what is the choice of the attire today?
Well, I mean, if you followed me throughout the 16 years that I've been an MP, each day we are voting, I've always been in a white attire. I mean, white symbolizes peace, it symbolizes calm, it also symbolizes victory. So I'm very confident that by the gifts of God, democracy will be victorious today, no matter what happened. I mean, so far, all of us have seen the process is going very well, it's very calm. Almost every police station has started very well. 206 police stations across the constituency, and I've taken updates from all my reps across the constituency. It is going on very well. It's very calm. It is our prayer that it will continue this way till the end. We'll get the counting, we'll get skirmishes, we'll go and collect, and let democracy be victorious.
And you have said that this has been so cool, everything is moving on so smooth. Before the elections, you had raised some concerns. Do you think that most of them have been resolved or part have been resolved?
Well, what I would say is that, I mean, if you notice, early in the morning, there were some young men, 10 of them on motorbikes in New Zongo. Fortunately, the military were there, and they were able to quickly arrest them. And I want to believe that that's the only incident so far we've had. Even they were not on offensive, but the way they were moving in a group, I mean, sent some wrong whiffs. And we are happy that the military were able to deal with it. I'm happy that all the issues that we raised with regards to the attempt to what we call run over us, the presence of the security is helpful. It is my prayer that the security are not going to relax to say that, oh, so far it's good, so maybe let's move out of our Swansea. And then they will move out and something nasty happens. It is our prayer that they continue to be vigilant, they continue to patrol the streets. I have told, if you notice, you don't see any NDC young men going around. I told them, nobody, you are either deployed at a police station or you have no business saying that you are monitoring on the streets of Swansea. So we are not asking anybody to be in a group monitoring anything. We trust the security people, they will do what is fair, what is just, and it is also our expectation that the electoral commission staff will also do their work. And there have been some number of incidents, and I'm happy that the security intervened, where the IOC says the police agents should go far away. And it was also becoming a skirmish in Ababu School Park, that's where my office is. And the military, the police came, look at the law and said, no, you don't have the right to say they should go far away. The law said they should stand where they can see what is happening. So they have to stand where they can see. And I thought that that's very good from the security guys. But previously, you see them saying that, oh, what the EC official says is final. But the law is there, and the book is giving, we got the book to give it to every agent. So we are happy that so far, we are all following the rules. I have told a number of the security guys that I've met that, look, if we cross the line, deal with us. If any other person crosses the line, equally deals with that person. That's the only way you allow this, you ensure this sanctity to continue to the end. If you begin to sway and try to be persuasive when the law is being breached, then you'll be contributing to destabilizing the process. I must say, I'm very happy. I mean, we've all prayed, we've talked, we've done everything humanly possible, and I want to believe that it is yielding results, because so far, I mean, it's almost 11 o'clock. That's almost, we are almost getting to 4 hours after the opening of the, what we call it, the start of the registration, the voting, that will not help anything at once. We continue to pray to God that it will control this way to the end.
There's been an intensified military patrol or security patrol in the area. Are you okay with it?
I'm very, very okay. I mean, I'm happy. I've told our people, they shouldn't fail. They are here to protect us. They are here to ensure that we all follow the law. They are here to ensure that the right things are done. So we have no reason to be scared. We should just come out in our numbers and make sure that we are voting right. So I'm sure my constituents are not intimidated by the presence of the military, because they are not doing anything untoward. We just pray that it will control this way till the end.
One interesting thing happened when you went to cast your vote. You used your daughter's tampon to do that. Why do you do that?
Well, I mean, she's only six. She doesn't even understand what's happening. So I said, I pick a thumb, but I do a thumb printing. So it's literally me doing it. Well, if I'm giving it to her, she will not even know what to do. So, I mean, she's my princess, and I've always come here with her for the past, the last election, I mean, with this team. So it's just to get her to the process, yes.
Finally, what is the hope for you in today's election?
I have no doubt in my mind that the people of Asante are going to return me. I have the least doubt. I mean, you yourself judge my performance from Parliament, judge my performance in the constituency. I am super confident that they are going to retain me at the close of today. I know I've done a lot of good things. I'm not an angel. I have my weakness and I have my strength. I believe my strength far outweighs my weakness. And the good people of Asante know that, and I know by the gifts of God, they are going to return me at the close of the day.
That's a member of Parliament for the Asante constituency.